Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you both for your true heroic efforts, both today and also throughout your careers. I'd like to start with you, Mr. Kent. In your testimony, you said that you had, in mid-August, it became clear to me that Giuliani's efforts to gin up politically motivated investigations were now infecting U.S. engagement with Ukraine, leveraging President Zelensky's desire for a White House meeting. Mr. Kent, did you actually write a memo documenting your concerns that there was an effort underway to pressure Ukraine to open an investigation to benefit President Trump?
Yes, ma'am. I wrote a memo to the file on August 16th.
But we don't have access to that memo, do we?
I submitted it to the State Department subject to the September 27th subpoena.
And we have not received one piece of paper from the State Department relative to this investigation. Both of you have made compelling cases of the importance of Ukraine to Europe, to the 70 years of peace, the benefit that it has to the United States' national security, and our goal to continue to support sovereignty of nations. Meanwhile, Russia is violently attacking people in Ukraine in the Donbas area. So withholding military aid, does that weaken Ukraine?
Well, I think it sends the wrong signal, and it did for a short period of time. Again, the assistance from the FY19 was released and is in the process of heading towards Ukraine.
Does it embolden Russia when there was no aid being sent to Ukraine?
I think the signal that there's controversy and question about the U.S. support of Ukraine sends the signal to Vladimir Putin that he can leverage that as he seeks to negotiate with not only Ukraine but other countries.
Thank you. Ambassador Taylor, I think you mentioned that a White House meeting for Zelensky would boost his ability to negotiate for a peaceful settlement with Vladimir Putin and Russia in general. Is that true?
Ms. Speier, it is certainly true that that U.S. support for Mr. Zelensky, President Zelensky, in his negotiations with Russians is very important and will enable him to get a better agreement with that support from the United States, both from the military assistance, but also just from the political assistance that we can provide.
But he has not yet had that White House meeting, has he?
He has not.
I think it's ironic that Soviet-born Lev Parnas, who has now been indicted, had a meeting with the president in the White House after participating in a number of campaign events for the president and contributing $325,000 to the president's PAC. So maybe it's actually the requirement that you give money to the president's PAC in order to get that meeting at the White House. Ambassador Taylor, is it true that the Prosecutor General now has opened an investigation in Ukraine?
Ms. Speier, the new Prosecutor General that President Zelensky has appointed is indeed investigating crimes in general. Is that your question?
Yes.
But yes, he is in office and is investigating criminal activity.
Has he specified what investigations he's undertaken?
No.
He has not. All right. I yield the rest of my time to chairmanship.